as I mentioned, Patrick Coffin is the founder and president of Patrick Coffin Media, and he is just doing amazing things. He has been gone from Catholic Answers Live for a while. His website's patrickcoffin.net and also patrickcoffin.media. He has written books. One is called Sex au Naturel, what it is and why it's good for your marriage. He wrote Stay Cool When the Argument Heats Up, and he joins us. Patrick, how you doing?
Hey, Dave. Great to talk to you, sir. God bless you. Yeah, thanks for having me.
Good to hear your voice again. I don't hear it as often as I used to, but I know you're still got a big media presence out there. But looking forward to talking with you and also welcoming you to North Texas next month for the big conference.
Well, I left Catholic Answers Live about a year and a half ago to start my own podcast and YouTube channel, which is I went for a really unusual title, The Patrick Coffin Show. I hope folks can figure it out. It's a weekly show in which I do commentary and mainly interviews with influencers in the area of faith and culture. Topics from what's a real man to the effects of a porn addiction, the fallout of divorce in the lives of children, how to understand the founding documents in light of the Catholic faith. So it's sort of a look at faith and culture through a Catholic lens. It's not quote unquote Catholic media so much as a look at things in light of the gospel. And so I reach out. I've got people who are atheists, people who are outside the Catholic fold, who are really, they've got fascinating insights into the culture. So that sort of cultural renewal is the sweet spot. Well, the mindset is I'm a sinner like every single attendee, and the men who come to the North Texas Catholic Men's Conference are going to learn a lot of the fruit of my mistakes and the change, sort of mindset changes that I've gone through as a disciple. And mainly, I think if you summarize my message to the men in a single phrase, it's that men are accustomed to being providers, and that's great. We are fishers of men. We are meant to be active disciples on purpose. But in heaven, which is the final goal, we will not be providers. We will be provided for. And so that being provided for by our Heavenly Father has to be the first step. In other words, before you're a leader, before you're a husband, before you're a father, you are a son. And a lot of men walk around with what Reverend Gordon Dalby calls a father wound. So I'm talking about the importance of seeing yourself primarily as a son of the Father. That's sort of our deepest identity. I also talk about movies that resonate with men and why that is, and talk about the importance of father figures, or if not, you know, biological fathers. And there's no such thing as a perfect earthly father, but I think great things happen when Catholic men get together under one roof to grow closer to Christ. And every single event, there's always someone who hasn't been, haven't darkened the doors to a church in years, sometimes decades. And they just get ignited by the Holy Spirit within the sight of their fellow brothers in Christ, wanting to grow, wanting to learn and stretch a little bit out of their comfort zone. So I love being with men. I love talking about discipleship and that servant leadership that our Lord calls us.
You know, something occurred to me is that since the last North Texas Catholic Men's Conference, there has been a lot of attention on men in the culture. You got the Me Too movement. You've got the Harvey Weinstein thing, blew up, since then. And Patrick, I don't know if this is something that changes the dynamic of how you approach a men's conference, but men are in the crosshairs, and rightly so in many reasons. They also had the comment from that comedian after the Parkland shootings where he said, boys are broken. I'm sure that crossed you saw that, where there's this conversation right now about boys are broken, men are broken, men are doing a lot of stupid stuff and are in need of help. So any comment on that and how that might influence your talk next month?
Well, great question, Dave. I think there's a lot of truth behind the need to speak up when men abuse women, whether it's Hollywood or Wall Street or, Walmart. Whenever misbehavior gets exposed, it's always a great thing because the devil loves secrets. By the same token, men are now afraid to be leaders because they think that masculine leadership is going to be identified with authoritarianism or kind of lording it over people. And I find a lot of men secretly think one thing, but don't really want to say it out loud.
Mm-hmm.
Like to say that the man is the head of the household. Well, that's like complete heresy now. But if you understand head as servant leader, and every head has to have a heart, and that belongs to the mother, you see the beautiful complementarity of the Catholic vision for men and women, that if men do their jobs and be those imitators of Christ, there would be no feminist movement. What woman doesn't want an adventure in which she is the subject and the aim is to help her, to help her blossom? So I think while the hashtag MeToo movement has become kind of politicized and one-sided, men have to take responsibility for what they do. And the higher the standard for male behavior, the more men are likely to take it up. You know, Jesus calls us sheep. If the standard bar is low, then men will aim for it. If it's higher, then they'll aim for that as well. So this is a long-winded way of saying that men are broken. Women are broken because we're all sons and daughters of our first parents.
Yeah.
The good news is we have the restoration. His name's Jesus Christ, and his good news that we're all equally beloved by God, and that has to be the starting point.
You know, we talk about, Patrick made that great point about men are sometimes afraid to speak out. And sometimes, I think our heads are just spinning because the culture is so crazy. And Patrick, I want to ask you, you probably more as much as anybody, Bishop Barron may be in league with you, but watching the culture, commenting on the culture. And I think of that Billy Joel song about, we didn't start the fire. There's always been wackiness. There's always been craziness. But there's something going on right now that's kind of hard to define, a confusion about gender and sex and, a whole lot of things. How would you put your finger on what's going on right now in the culture and perhaps the remedy as well?
Well, it's very easy. That's a great reference to the Billy Joel, We Didn't Start the Fire, because it has a double-edged sword to it. On the one hand, the craziness has always been here because there's a little thing called original sin, which Chesterton said is the only self-evident dogma of the Catholic Church. All you need to do is read a newspaper. On the other hand, it's also true that the fire of the Holy Spirit was not invented by us. We didn't start that fire either. And the Holy Spirit is always enough. He's always, able to inspire and empower and raise up men and women in the answer to the confusions. And one of the antidotes that he sent for the failed sexual revolution came before the revolution hit, and that is Father Karol Wojtyła, later St. John Paul II. All the things he was writing about as an archbishop working with families became in full bloom with the theology of the body, which is the antidote to the sexual revolution. It's not, sex is dirty, our bodies are bad. No, sex is better than good. It's holy. So the Catholic vision for sex and marriage and romance is much higher than the cultural ideal. We just need to have a light shed on the truth of it and let it out of its cage. So I think commentators like Bishop Barron and others who are even outside the faith, they have a sense that people are not hardwired for confusion. We're not built to receive chaos. We're built to receive order. So when you hear order, especially when men, because men tend to be, law-oriented and I won't say rules-based, but men are much more likely to be law and order types. When they hear that message of order and organization and truth, something comes alive. And there definitely is something going on in the hearts of men across the country, a recognition of this father wound, a recognition that sometimes big boys do cry, and that a real man is a man who's real. So those are kind of the subcategories of the things I'll be talking about at the conference.